This is Sophie. She's gonna make me a training droid to help enhance my Jedi training.
All right, let's try this again.
This video is sponsored by KiwiCo. The future of play is engaging, enriching, and seriously fun. It's one thing to build a lightsaber, but wielding a lightsaber is entirely different. Jedi go through years and years of training, traditionally starting as younglings, progressing to Padawans, before ascending to Jedi Knight. And you know, maybe someday being granted the title of Master.
Hello there.
But hey, we all know Luke didn't start as a youngling, and he only saved the galaxy. So I think it's fine to start at a more advanced age of 30. Speaking of Padawans, here at Hacksmith Industries, we take on co-ops from a variety of tech backgrounds and experiences to help them refine their practical hands-on skills. And because projects take months and months to complete, we need a team of engineers to manage to come out with a new video week after week after week. This is Sophie from the University of Waterloo. She studies mechanical engineering, and according to this, she's also a member of the Waterloo rocketry team. She clearly knows a lot about sci-fi tech. Hired. She'll be with us for the next 4 months, and in those 4 months, she's gonna make me a training droid to help enhance my Jedi training. And by the next 4 months, I actually mean the previous 4 months, because in typical Hacksmith fashion, we're actually filming the intro of this video at the end of the project. Anyway, I guess I better get started training.
To build our training droid, the first thing we're going to need is a camera that can recognize, and more importantly, track people. Fortunately for us, this camera already exists. It's called the Z2. Made by Stereo Labs, this camera is the full package. It's built for the spatial AI era with its big power and small form factor. But how exactly are we going to make this camera fly? I could just use the Force. But that isn't always exactly, shall we say, practical. So, we're going to rely on drone technology. No, not droid, drone. I spent the better part of a month researching the components that go into building a custom drone, and settled on these. First, we found the receiver, the FreeSky X8R. It uses the S-Bus communication protocol to take instructions from the remote control. We want to make this drone as powerful as possible, so we got this 3000 milliamp-hour 6-cell LiPo battery to power the entire thing. Next up, we have the T-Motor F4 flight controller. This is the brains of the drone, the Leia Organa of the operation. It takes the instructions from the receiver and tells the motors what they need to do. Paired with the flight controller is the T-Motor 55 Amp Pro 2 Electronic Speed Controller, ESC for short. It takes in the instructions from the flight controller and gives the motors a certain amount of current so that they spin. Next, we have a question of optimization. Those who know drones know that they're a balancing act between rotational speed and power. You need both of those to push the air down and create thrust. We chose the T-Motor Velox 2208 KV1750 motors and the T-Motor 5147 propellers. That's a lot of numbers that have specific meanings, but I don't have time to explain that to you right now. Together, these generate 6,800 grams of thrust. They're the perfect duo, like Han Solo and Luke Skywalker blasting TIE fighters out of the sky. All of these components get strapped to a frame. This is just a prototype, so we laser cut two layers of wood with lots of holes for the flight controller stack, the battery, the receiver, and the motors. And finally, the remote controlling business comes in with the transmitter, the FreeSky Tyrannus. It's got all the buttons and switches I'll need to control the drone. Let's assemble this thing and make sure it works.
Jedi strength flows from the Force. But beware of the dark side.
Okay, let's see if this thing can fly.
Consume you it will.
People are constantly asking us how we got started in engineering, which is why we're thrilled to partner with KiwiCo. So thrilled that we're giving our viewers 50% off their first monthly crate. Sometimes when you're small, it's easier to think big. But KiwiCo creates hands-on projects and toys designed to expose kids to concepts in STEAM, science, technology, engineering, art, and math. They believe that the small lessons today can mean big world-changing ideas tomorrow. Each monthly crate comes with all the supplies needed, detailed kid-friendly instructions, plus an educational magazine for further learning. With 8 subscription lines, each catering to a different age group and skill set, there's something for everyone. I may not have kids myself, but after completing a few of these kits, I can't think of a better way to get kids interested in making things. Check out kiwico.com/hacksmith50 for 50% off your first crate. Any crate, just click on the link in the description below. Plus, you'll be helping to support our channel.
What about guns? The droid needs to fire something at the person training. Unfortunately, lasers like in the movie don't exist in real life. But Nerf does, and we have like 400 Nerf bullets left over from the Screaming Gun project. To fire these little guys, I'll have to design a custom launching mechanism. SolidWorks? SolidWorks. This is the mechanism I designed. I'll show you how it works. It starts with 2 3D printed parts. Inside of that are 2 motors that spin together and launch the ball through. We've got a gating system to control the firing rate, and it moves in that way, controlled by the servo motor here. I'm happy with this design. Let's print it. Our 3D prints have finished, so we can start to build the launching mechanism. We've got a pipe here to act as the magazine. It'll hold about 10 Nerf bullets. We've got motors to launch them, some other pieces for a gating mechanism, a servo motor, tons of nuts and bolts to piece it all together, and my trusty glue gun. Pew pew! So we have our camera, our drone, and our gun. Problem is, they're stupid. They don't play nicely together. So we need them to get together and sing Kumbaya. To do that, we'll write some code. The computer needs to talk to the camera, the computer needs to talk to the gun, the computer needs to talk to the drone, and I need to talk to my mom. And you should talk to yours. She misses you. I've spent literally 3 months working on this code. It's the coolest and most infuriating part of this project.
This is the most complicated software that we've ever written in Hacksmith Industries. Even more complicated than the software that runs Bogdan.
What?
Never mind.
We wrote the code and run the code on the NVIDIA Jetson. The Jetson Xavier NX is a powerful little computer. It has 6 CPU cores and 8 gigabytes of RAM. It's designed to run computer vision and machine learning algorithms. The camera plugs into the Jetson. And the gun plugs into... Blast! The camera plugs in easily via USB, but the gun, flight controller, and receiver all need something different. They're trying to talk to each other, but they're just speaking different languages. If only we had C-3PO to act as interpreter.
How did we get into this mess?
It's time to hop into Altium Designer and make our own 3PO, a PCB. Altium Designer is the industry standard for PCB design. You can download it and try it for free at www.altium.com/yt/thehacksmith. There's also Altium Viewer, a free online platform that allows people to view all kinds of file formats. C-3PO has arrived. It connects onto the output pins of the NVIDIA Jetson and connects all of our hardware. Finally, they're all speaking the same language that the Jetson can understand. Check out the full electronic schematic on maker.io. On paper, everything should work. But let's put it to the test. We've got the camera and the gun hooked up to the Jetson. We've got a monitor connected to the camera so we can watch the live output. When the camera recognizes a person, the Jetson should tell the gun to fire. Let's see if it works. Okay, all we need now is a person to shoot at. I guess I'm a person. Ah! Oh my gosh, it works! Ah! Okay, this is awesome, oh my goodness. Ah! Ah! Okay, now that we know everything works, we can move on to the final assembly. This will include a new frame with mounting points for all of the hardware. We'll attach everything to that. It's time to put this thing to the test. I just have to find a way to lure James here. He's been training pretty hard. I bet he's pretty thirsty.
Water. Maximus' door. That's weird.
Oh, jeez!
Alright, this is pretty fun, but we didn't make the world's first plasma-based lightsaber not to use it. All right, let's try this again. All right, that's not actually working very well. That's because despite this plasma lightsaber being super hot, because the Nerf balls are flying so fast, they don't actually have enough time to melt when they're flying through the blade. Luckily, we also have our tungsten titanium lightsaber, which has a solid blade. All right, my Jedi training has paid off. That was freaking awesome. The tungsten titanium solid blade definitely works.
All right, this is freaking awesome. Our very own Star Wars training drone. Who doesn't want a drone that can target you and shoot you to help you become a Jedi? I think it's freaking awesome. You did a fantastic job, Sophie, and I just wanted to present you with a little certificate to remember your time here at Hacksmith Industries. Best of luck with the rest of your degree, and if you guys want to be an intern, make sure you check out our website on the careers page or apply through your local high school or university.